How interesting is your life right now? Actually, it's really compelling, isn't it? Super compelling. Welcome to January 22nd. This is the first day of the next phase. First day of the next phase. And everything is absolutely on track, playing out exactly as expected. Last night, I hit an all-time low. I realized that my life has ground to a complete dead end. You know, finished and no hope anywhere. And I said, okay, that's interesting. And then I said, wow, thank you, Longchenpa, for the amazing turnaround that's about to happen. So instead of panicking and, right, thinking, oh my gosh, no, I'm blocked, oh, going panic, I smiled and I said, wow, perfect setup for the ultimate turnaround. And I said, wow, thank you, Longchenpa, for the awesome turnaround that you're going to present. You see? So you might wonder, what good is all this effort and training and, you know, well, there you have it. When you hit the ultimate dead end, which I did, I said, wow, you know, this is really low. And then smiled and said, okay, great. Perfect setup. This should be fun. This is going to be great. So then I went to bed, and then I woken up like 2 in the morning with heartburn, terrible heartburn, then a sick stomach and everything. I can't sleep. So I started practicing. I said, okay, what do I need to practice? And I started to lock in on a practice. A practice arose for me. And a refuge practice. So on the 22nd of January, note this down, we shifted over to refuge practice. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Very, very simple practice. And what I found is the most amazing thing. When you take start doing refuge practice, you will find that there's all sorts of mental apps running in the background of your mind that want to control your expectations, that expect you to do what they want you to do. Okay, when you come into this world's full of expectations, and the world expects you, your life to be this way, and it commandeers your life. And so all these apps are running in the deep background. And as you say, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa, Dharmakaya, Buddha Guru, Bodhisattva Longchenpa. These apps have to defend their territory, you know. They say, no, you're going to do what I tell you to do. You're gonna live out my expectations. This is how I expect life to be, and you're going to be a witness to that, you see. And so they start arising, and you become aware of them. They try to seize control of your attention. It's amazing what happens. I said, holy cow. Some of the stuff is particularly interesting. You find out who in the world is trying to control your life, expects you to live a life the way they expect you to live it, you see? You find out in the world, you know, what is it that is pushing you, you know, to pushing a set of expectations on you to live life the way they want it to be for their benefit, okay? So you have to go to the Dharmakaya Buddha Guru, Bodhisattva Longchenpa, who will give you life expectations for your life, which are perfect, exactly how it will, so that it will be optimal for you and liberate you from delusion, you see. So you have to trust in the guru here. Trust in the guru is essential right now. So I trust Longchenpa. I said, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. In other words, I'll live my life according to the expectations that Longchenpa has for my life, you see? That's better than my expectations. It's better than anyone else's expectations other than the great gurus. They all have the same basic set of expectations for our life. So I'll let his expectations be how my life goes, and not the expectations of some demagogues in the world that are, you know, wow, this world is a snaky place, I'll tell you. So as you practice taking refuge, and this phase we're in now, starting today, the 22nd, is all about taking refuge. All about taking refuge. Expectational refuge. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. You get that? Okay. Now, you can use a guru of your choice. You have to trust that their expectations for your life are going to be you know, exactly what you want, actually. It could be, you know, whoever you have as your Ishta Guru, the one that is, you feel, you know, that their expectations for your life are going to make your life everything that you want it to be, actually. And it'll work out wonderfully. You'll get liberated from this dream of delusion. Everything will work out the way you really want it. This is called taking refuge in the Guru. Rama Maharshi spoke about this. He says, turn your life over to me. I will manage everything for you, he says. Let go and let God. I will manage every bit of your life. I promise you. This is how your job is to let go. Okay. Turn your life over to the greater power. Okay, the truth, the grace of God. And then that will manage everything for you. So this is the key. And so I decide I have nowhere else to go. My life is at a, you know, dead end, complete dead end. So I said, okay, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. What are Longchenpa's expectations for quote-unquote life? Okay, life. So let his expectations be how my life goes, how this life goes, how life appears. I'll be part of that, of his expectations for life. What is that? Well, he knows perfectly well how to manage all of that and how that goes and what it's all about, actually. So there you go, taking refuge. So it's necessary right now to take refuge. So our emphasis is on that. And because I found out that there are these apps running in the background of our mind. And again, when you start practicing your refuge practice, I take refuge in the life expectations of dot, dot, dot. You know, it can be your choice, right? Your choice. You have to trust it. You have to just turn it over and trust it. Turn it over and trust it. I'm just taking full refuge. I'm taking full and perfect refuge in the life expectations of Dharmakaya Buddha Guru, Bodhisattva Longchenpa. Okay, plain and simple. So he's the one now that is, his life expectations for me are how my life is going to go. Okay. And when you do that again, these apps, mental apps that have been controlling your expectations, they have to come up and defend. And that's when they start arising. Holy cow, I went through so many this morning. Wow, 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 wow. But all the meditation I've been doing recently made it possible for me to do this. I kept going because I've been doing, the last month or so I've had the flu, I've been doing so much repetitive meditation, staying with one idea and just sticking with it, and all this interference keeps coming up. So I've had some practice with it enough, so I was able to just stick with it. It wasn't too difficult. It's crucial, though, that I'd be able to do this. And you find out who wants to control your life. Okay, that comes up. What is it that's demanding that you do, that you live your life according to their expectations for you? Okay, that's what you become aware of. And these are these apps running, like on a smartphone, you have these apps. Yesterday I had this app, Google Fit. I downloaded it. I was really in a moment of weakness. And I said, well, maybe I should keep track of my steps, just something to do, you know. But no, that's focus on becoming, right? And so then I turned it off, the app off. It's off. It shouldn't be doing anything. But my phone started getting really hot, and it stayed hot, heaty, and the battery was going down. The phone was like really hot to my touch, like, wow, something's wrong. I couldn't figure out what it was. Finally, it was suggested to me, disable all apps. Disable all apps. I did that. The phone started cooling down. And then I looked and I saw there's two apps running in the background, and this Google Fit and another one. And I said, huh, it's never happened before. I just downloaded this app. It's happening now. Let me uninstall this app. I uninstalled it. Poof, problem solved. Okay, so it somehow, even when you turn the app off, it's not being used. It's running in the background and just burning the phone up. It was terrible. Well, I thought, I wonder if there's some apps running in the background of our mind, mental apps running in the background of our minds that we're not even aware of. I said, you know, I bet there is. I really bet that there is. And so in doing this refuge practice, suddenly, as I took refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa, these other expectations, these apps, suddenly said, hey, no, you're doing what I'm telling you to do. This is what I expect you to do. You're supposed to. You're like, wow, there are these apps running in the deep background of our mind. You have to disable them. Just disable all of them. Wow. We got so much junk running in the back of our minds. Meditation is the way to clear out all that junk, to disable all those apps. The life we're living is not the life we want to live, actually. It's living according to expectations, egoic expectations, actually. And we wonder, who's in control of my life? I just don't seem to, it's not going the way I really want it to go. Wow. It's these background apps of expectations that are demanding, that are very demanding. And there's all sorts of power structures in this world of expectations that expect you to do what they tell you to do. They want you to live your life a certain way, and they expect that, expect it. And then you fall into this trap of living it that way. The trap of expectations is the number one trap we have. Forget about anything else. Focus just on expectations. That's where it is really happening, actually. It's like invisible. We hardly know it's even happening. We say, I don't know what's wrong with me. But, expectation. Others expect you. You come into this world and this massive expectation on you from all directions to be a certain way. To live your life a certain way, to have a certain kind of life, a vulnerable life, or this type of life, do what they want you to do, so much of that. So the refuge practice, you will experience this. Just, you get knocked, something's trying to knock you off your focus. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So his expectations are now guiding my life and control of my life, you see? And as you do this, this will rattle the cages of all those deep mind apps that are expect you to do what they're telling you to do. It really rattles their cage, and they come up roaring like, hey, what's going on here? Just ignore them. Don't get in any sort of battle with them. Don't criticize them at all. Just say, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So right now, it's super important not to be critical of anything, because that doesn't reinforce your taking refuge at all. If you start saying, hey, you're a bad person, you're trying to get me to do what you expect, why are you doing that? I don't want you to stop doing that. You're losing your power then. But if you just ignore it and just say, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Just keep that. Those deep apps, it disables them. It disables them. Yeah. And you find them just pretty soon, they're not there anymore. So don't argue, don't criticize, don't complain, just take refuge. Just keep asserting, I take refuge in the life expectations of .. We'll just use Longchenpa here. For the purpose of illustrating this, and this is what I'm taking refuge in, Dharmakaya, Buddha Guru, Bodhisattva Longchenpa, I take refuge in the life expectations of Dharmakaya, Buddha Guru, Bodhisattva Longchenpa. Okay. And then so he will manage my life now. He's in charge of what I experience. His expectations are what I will be experiencing going forward. And it's a better deal than all those deep apps that were controlling me. I'll tell you that. Their way brought me to a dead end. Okay. Their expectations that my life is going to come to a dead end, okay? And it had. So I said, hey, okay, but guess what? I have an ace up my sleeve. That's the whole thing I've been working on in my life. You know what? I'm going to have an ace up my sleeve. And now's the time to play that ace. And it's like, it completely, what? straight flush, ace high, you know. Got it. So, knockout blow. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. This is a taking refuge practice, the most powerful practice I've ever come across. And I knew that Longchenpa would come up with something. I kept saying, thank you, Longchenpa, for the tremendous escape plan that you have, the tremendous turnaround you're going to do in my life. I know you're going to do it. And I'm just waiting for it, but you're going to do it. I know. Thank you for the great turnaround. So all these years I'm going along and suffering and thinking my life's going to hell. And instead of complaining, I would say, no, this, you know, let me thank Longchenpa for the fabulous escape that he has for me. Wow. I know it's there. It has to be there. He can't possibly have come to me without the remedy. You know, what guru comes to you and says, you can trust me without any remedy for the troubles? Of course he has a remedy. So I didn't know what it was, but I thanked him in advance. I said, I know you have it, so thank you. That's fabulous. Really, really wonderful. Wow, wow, wow. So I wowed it ahead of time. Wow it ahead of time. Wow results that you know are there ahead of time. Okay, wow them ahead of time. So then when they come, you say, yeah. So this has arrived. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow, wow. Sudden, my life was at an end. Suddenly, it's not a dead end. Longchenpa has transformed it. Flipped the script entirely. And Longchenpa just means the grace of God, really. The grace of God. The grace of God. In a way that is, we feel comfortable with, you see. The gurus just help us in give us a comfort zone with the grace of God. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So his expectations for my life are now what's ruling my life, not the expectations of those snakes. Yeah. That have brought my life to a dead end, you see. That's what they wanted for me. That's what those, yeah, absolutely. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So I get up this morning and I don't have any work. And it's like, what? Someone calls me for work and then they get some work and then they cancel it. So I said, why don't I just tape right now? Because this is what's really happening. This is the crucial day. And right on cue, this wonderful escape from our troubles, taking refuge in the guru, the life expectations of the guru. Suddenly that's present like that. Wow. Perfect timing. Perfect timing. And the heartburn, all that was part of the timing. Like, oh, gee, I can't sleep. Oh, let me practice then. You see, perfect. So you, when you're sick, say, hey, this is a great opportunity, isn't it? So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, 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 wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, 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 wow. So I don't know how this is going to go. That's okay. It's going to go fabulous, of course. But I'll just one day at a time, you know, just to stay in the moment and practice. Stay in the moment and practice. Now, when you're removing these blocks, when you start practicing, you may feel you're not getting anywhere at first. Really. That was yesterday. Bodhisattva Manjushri, already found, already free. Bodhisattva Manjushri, already found, already free. Already found. I'm already found, already free. And so I'm practicing yesterday, and I just, you know, it's not get anywhere, kind of like. But I just kept doing it compulsively, just kept working at it, kept working at it. It's kind of like, at first, you don't think you're getting anywhere. But you're loosening up a little bit at a time, a little bit at a time, a little bit, like a boulder. You're loosening it up. And then gradually it starts getting, or it's like you're trying to pull like some sign out of the dirt, out of the ground, you know. It doesn't seem to move at all first. So you keep pushing from each post, keep pushing from every angle, and gradually get a little bit of wiggle in it, right? And then as you keep working out, you get more and more wiggle, as you move the post around and push it this way, pull it this way. And then gradually you start getting a lot of wiggle room, and then suddenly, poof, you pull the post out of the ground. Practice is a lot like that, pulling a post that's embedded in the ground out. You just have to keep getting a little more wiggle room, a little more wiggle to it. Okay, and at first, you think, wow, I don't know if this is going to work. But you have to just do it anyway. Already found, already free. I'm already found, already free. Already found, intrinsic spaciousness has found me. Bodhisattva Manjushri, intrinsic spaciousness has already found me. Bodhisattva Manjushri, intrinsic spaciousness has already found me. Okay, yeah. So, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. So this is the start to the next phase here. Taking refuge exactly to the day that we needed it. And we absolutely need to take refuge now. Okay. The expectations that this world has for us are rampaging right now. Okay. They're on the rampage. Okay. But we don't. I had fallen into bad habits last night. I realized I'd fallen into really bad habits. I was just, my life had collapsed. All my discipline, everything. I was looking at the news, doing everything that I don't do, sports scores, things. Those are things I had banned, and I had, for years and years and years, I hadn't done any of that. And here I was now just like addicted to it suddenly. Suddenly, I said, wow, I've just lost all hope. All my discipline's gone. But I said, well, I've got to get it back somehow. I don't know what's next, but it's time to turn the page. Something new has to come into the picture here to help this out. Oh, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. New chapter, just like that. So we've turned the page and we're now in this new chapter, just like that. That's how it happens. And it was the page turning time from the evening of January 21st to the morning of January 22nd. That's when this chapter page turned. I turned the chapter page exactly in the time frame that it was supposed to happen. And I expected it to happen. So we're in this new chapter, taking refuge in the grace of God. You can say it that way, however you want to say it. See, I take refuge in the life expectations, you could say, of the grace of God. I take refuge in the life expectations of the grace of God. But I believe it's more helpful to have some more concrete frame of reference. Okay, if you leave it completely abstract like that, it could get a little tough for you, because we're still talking about functioning as a body in this world. Okay, the life in this world, and that we take it to be a life of a body, you know, it, and other people. So if it's too abstract, I believe it could be too difficult for most of us. So it's better to have a guru there that gives you a little more concrete frame of reference there. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. And you feel like they understand the struggles that we have here with a body and the life in this world. Okay, they've been through it. Okay. They've been through it. They've been helped through it. So it gives you this sort of comfort zone. Like, I know they'll be able to manage the expectations of my life. They'll have my life go the way that they expect it to go. So now my life is going to go the way Longchenpa expects it to go. Okay. Rather than some snake expects it to go, you know? So that's why taking refuge in the guru means your life is now going to go the way they expect it to go, and they expect it to go perfectly. They expect it to go wonderfully. They expect it to go successfully. They expect it to go in such a way that, wow, you're even going to enter into the great perfection. I mean, it's going to go just marvelous for you. Okay, for us. Just marvelous. So, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. What does Longchenpa expect from life? I'll take refuge in that. Okay. He knows exactly what it's all about. Exactly. Perfectly. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I'm sure you've heard of the taking refuge in the guru. Well, that's what we're doing right here. That's actually what's taking place now. This is the chapter of taking refuge. Perfectly on right moment for it. And certainly, it's something that we must do. We must do if we want our lives to go well for us now, really well. This is what is necessary, because the demands, the expectational demands that are coming from this planet right now are absolutely atrocious for you, okay? Unbelievably bad for you. And so we cannot go with that anymore at all. Yeah. And so I just drew the lines, okay, that's it. That's it, no more. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa, okay? That's it. Someone's going to run your expectations. You're going to have a set of expectations as long as you're in this world. Okay. You better put that set of expectations. Let perfection set the expectations for you. Let immaculate perfection set the expectations for you and manage the expectations for you in the right way. Okay. It's a no-brainer. And so Rama Maharshi, I took to heart what he said. He said, truly surrender your life to the guru. The guru will manage everything for you perfectly. Nanda Maima said the same thing. I read that like yesterday. Same thing. Put it all in God's hands, and God will arrange everything for you perfectly. If you truly trust in God and surrender to God, truly surrender your expectations to God, the grace of God will manage your life, manage everything for you. They all say this. Nisargadatta Maharaj said, all the gurus say this. And so I said, wow, okay, I'm going to trust this. I'm going to trust in this. There's nothing else to do, actually. And it's the awareness of these apps in the background, mental apps. I said, oh my goodness, we're so contaminated, aren't we? It's burning up our energy. Overheating us. We're getting all overheated. People are all overheated into emotionalism now, right? They're getting tired. They're getting depressed and mood disorder, all this stuff. Those are those apps that are running that are brutally, have brutal expectations for us, really terrible. But we don't try to do, I'm just mentioning this, but we're not going to get into a complaining mode about it at all. We're not complaining anymore about it. We're just saying, hey, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I'm, that's it. I'm done. I mean, that's all I have to do. I've done what I need to do. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So my life is going to be, it's going to be wow. It's going to be wow. It's going to be wow. So I don't know. So it's very interesting this morning. I'm thinking I haven't really thought what's going to happen because I'm more into practicing. So just keep practicing. Don't worry about what's going to happen. Just keep saying, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. And then we'll see what happens. I'm not worried about it. It's going to be wonderful. Okay. But I'm not trying to anticipate. I just wow. It's going to be wow. So the wow practice helps us take refuge. That's the key step where we don't think ahead. We don't worry. I know it's going to be wow. And that's all I need to know. That's all I need to know. So I just say, wow, 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 wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. You can step that out. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. or whoever you choose, you can put it into a walking practice. I take refuge. I take refuge. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. Yeah. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. Like that. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. So you'll have your epiphany. At some point, you might wake up in the morning with a sick stomach, heartburn, and you say, hey, let me start practicing taking refuge. And then you'll start doing it. And then you'll see the apps come up and complain about it. Say, hey, you got to do what I expect you to do. And just ignore it. Just keep saying, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Just all this stuff that comes up trying to pull you down, just ignore it. Don't react to it. Don't react to it. So it's the non-reactivity that is crucial. So we're mentioning it here, but without reactivity, okay? So as this arises, do not react to it in any way. You just notice it. You say, okay, something's arisen. Oh, okay, wow, I lost my train of thought for a second there. Okay, go back to what I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. No reactivity, and this keeps your practice very intrepid, and you'll find you're able to do it. As soon as you start being reactive, this is where you lose track, and your practice falls apart. So this intense reactivity of the world right now, okay, dangerous, dangerous thing. Meditation is all about dispassion and no reactivity. Something arises, you just notice it and just go back to your, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So I did a really good job this morning at this. So many, 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 many apps came up trying to, commandeer my attention and get me to react. And I just didn't react. I just kept going, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. See, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So, again, when you're practicing refuge practice, which is the practice now, don't react to the villains that arise, the deep apps, very villainous. Oh my goodness, they're trying to pull you back down into wretchedness, okay? Don't react at all. Don't react to them. Don't get angry at them. Don't get fearful of them. Don't get despair of that. Don't get shock or surprise or anything. Something has arisen, okay, fine. Now what my practice is? Oh, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. That's what you want. So you stay repeating what you want. You reinforce your expectations towards what you want. Say, this is what I expect. This is what I want, and this is what I expect. I want to take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. That's what I want. And then by repeating it, it becomes what I expect. So you have to have this want first. This is what I really want. And then repeat, 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 repeat. Just keep repeating it so much during a practice period you have whenever it happens. And then during the day and when you're walking, keep repeating it. And then it becomes what you expect. And once it becomes what you expect, then you're starting to be on really, really solid ground with it. You expect it. So there's no clash of expectations when it happens. You say, yeah, I expect this. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. So, of course, we're really here. What we want for you, what I want for me, is what I want for you. And that is, I want you to take refuge in the life expectations of perfection. So your experiencing will be, you know, wow. So wow. So wowish. Absolute wow. You know, it will be wow, wow, wow all the way through. Wow, 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 all the way home. And that's what I want for me, and that's therefore that's what I want for all of you. And so this is why I'm bringing this, emphasizing it's time to take refuge. This is it. This is it. This is how it's done, actually. Now, I knew this all along, but I didn't know exactly how I would do it. It's so simple, isn't it? I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So it's so simple and yet extraordinarily profound and effective. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. The expectations that Longchenpa has for quote-unquote life, not my life, but just life, okay? Not anyone's life in particular, but just life. And then his expectations for that, which are flawless, he will manage you to be in harmony with that, with all those the expectations. Perfect harmony with it, perfectly flowing, perfectly in harmony with it, you see? So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. Wonderful day for me, for you, and for Longchenpa, and for the grace of God, and for all gurus, and for everyone, actually. None of us really want to keep suffering, you know, really. So it's a great day for all beings for sure. It's a happy refuge day, everyone. January 22nd, it should be officially called Happy Refuge Day. Taking refuge in the life expectations of the Guru Day. Okay, that's January 22nd. For forevermore, I dub thee. Yeah, absolutely. It is. We will remember this. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. And you could even say, wow, wow. Wow, 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 wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Now, people are a little bit worried about me yesterday. I was complaining. I said, man, I think this is the lowest I've ever been. I mean, I just don't, you know, this is really just like unbelievable. I have no interest in anything. I don't want to do anything. I just lost all interest in life, and I can't. And it's just, you know, I don't see any way out at all. But I said, well, the turnaround is going to be really, really, really great. You know, I don't know what it's going to be, but it's going to be great. Thank you, Longchenpa, for your fabulous turnaround that you have. And it happened. Of course, it happened. Of course, it happened. So I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Now the deep apps are going to be complaining, saying, explain this to me. Don't explain anything. Just practice. See, when you're explaining, you're not practicing. And then you're not building expectations. And they know they have the upper hand because they've been in control for so long. And so you expect them to stay in control. So all that the resistance as you're meditating, all it's trying to do is to stop you from repeating what you're saying. Because as you repeat what you're saying, what you want, you're building expectations. And that's curtains for them. They know once you expect, okay, to take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa, once you expect that, they're finished. They don't have control over you anymore. They control you through expectation. So they try to get you engaged in argument and questions and answers and complaints and attacking them and all this stuff. But that's not reinforcing our expectation, right? I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. You have to keep repeating your intention. Don't deviate from it. Do not deviate from it. Do not deviate from it. Stay right on it. This is what I want, and by repeating it, it's going to be what I expect. Period. Okay, so I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Don't go off and say, oh, I love this so much. No. Stay right on point because you're building expectations here. You're grooving it. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So I just say this over and over and over and just keep going for hours and hours and, you know, just keep repeating exactly the same, pretty much exactly the same, right? You might do a little bit of embellishment here and there. That can happen. I did that. But you find you're going back to the simplest form is fine. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. It's much easier to remember. If you make it a little more complicated, it's easier to forget. So just go back to the simplest practice. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. And whatever arises, don't interact. Dispassionate, detached. Dispassionate detachment, no reaction to it. But you notice, oh, okay, something's real. He said, whatever that is, I know it doesn't like me. It's not nice, but you know, it's losing its grip on me. The very fact that it's alarmed enough to arise means it's losing its grip on you. It's losing its grip. I had some extraordinarily interesting experience with this. I don't want to get into that right now. Okay, it would be controversial. Let's put it that way. For sure. And I want to interject that on your practice. I don't want to give you some notion of this is what's going to arise in your practice. Okay, so this is something that certainly arose in my practice. Wow. Huh. A little bit scary in terms of, oh my goodness, yeah. So, you know, but who knows what's going to arise as you practice? I don't want to make expectations for you in your practice that way. You know, but stuff could arise that you'll say, wow, that's trying to control me, isn't it? Holy cow. Son of a gun. I had a feeling. You know, that's not too surprising, though. Wow, wow, wow. This world's in full control mode right now of your expectations, I'll tell you that, in a very negative way. But we just say, hey, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. So this is as good as it gets. Okay, if you're watching this, just realize this is as good as it gets right now. As good as it gets, we are in this new chapter of taking refuge. We know how to do it, and we have very clear encouragement and guidance right here of how to do it, okay? And we will continue. It's going to stay very clear and better and better and better and better if it's possible, but we'll stay on point here, and you'll be able to do it. You'll be able to do it. Now, maybe it takes desperation. Maybe it takes you hitting rock bottom like it took me. But who's to say you won't hit rock bottom coming up, right? So, you know, just start anticipating. Say, hey, thank you, so, you know, Longchenpa Guru, grace of God, thank you for this amazing turnaround, this miraculous turnaround. Wow. Thank you for this tremendous turnaround that you have for me. This miraculous turnaround you have for me. Thank you for this miraculous turnaround that you have for me. And so when you hit rock bottom, you'll say, oh, okay, it's time for this miraculous turnaround to take place. And it's the refuge, most likely it's going to be this refuge practice, okay? Very, very likely. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow, Wow. Okay. And I'm just using, you know, my practice to show you, but you might have another, again, you might have another guru or saint or whatever, however you want to look at it, okay? You might have your own, what you feel most comfortable with. So use that. I don't want to say it should be this alternative or that alternative thing. You'll know who you trust. So I trust Longchenpa. I trust him. He's my Ishta guru. He's the one that's helping me directly. Okay. He's the Dharmakaya form of pure grace of God. That is responsible for me. Okay. So I invoke him. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Wow. Okay, so there you have it. We're perfectly in sync, all right? We're right on track. It's all going exactly the way we want it to go, okay? And so, you know, I take refuge in the life expectations of Longchenpa. Very great. Wow.